bring all the HTML pages, store them on a server. That was a simple idea. But it became hit and people laughed at them when they presented their idea. But they were so convinced that they went ahead and they implemented the idea. So startup is like, you have to try. If there is any idea, you should try. You may fail, but again try. And when you are failing, you may get some other ideas. And like this, you have to grow, and these are the 4 years or 3 years are there for you. And you should not waste a single minute of time. And you should do something like this. Okay? Even YouTube, what is the idea of YouTube people? That let the people upload the video on their server. What is there with YouTube? They are having their server and they are having some website. On their website, they are showing their videos. And what they are saying, I am not preparing any video. You only prepare and you only see. And they are running through lots of ads. Okay, so that was a simple idea. And you are a brilliant student. Students are always brilliant this age. 18 to 25 is the age where you have lots of idea. But only you should be motivated to implement it and try.
And yes. Natural language processing. You may want to have an application that will, that blind person having any idea. You will be provided the facilities which you want. But we should see you somewhere sitting and continuously working on your idea. Then what
is you going to use your product or your service? Empathize your customer. Then you actually identify what you have to build. Define your problem statement properly. Then identify what are the multiple ways to implement your idea. And select the best implementation idea. Then build a prototype. Come up with the actual model. It may be a ugly prototype in the beginning, which is not looking good, but it is having all the functionality. Give that prototype to the end user. Identify 10-15 people. Give them free of cost your product to use. Take the feedback. Take each and everything of your feedback sincerely. Read it, test it, and then again by taking the feedback, you can again go back and start from any one of the stage. Like here in the other diagram, you can see this, that it is not a sequential order, but it is an iterative process where after testing you may go back and again start finding another way to solve the problem, or from the prototype you will learn something and again you will go back, or from here you will again go back and empathize the person. Like this, it is an iterative process to follow in the design thinking. Okay. So now what is the activity that we are going to build is that you make the group of, now we will have four groups. Okay. We'll have four groups. One first group here, first three bench, last three bench here also, first, last four bench are here, first three bench will go in. Now we can split that corner, this corner, or one group can be here only. Make the groups, four groups. We are giving you some material. Out of in your group, you identify two students as your customer. Okay, and then you talk to the customer, ask him what is the problem that customer is facing, and make a product for him. And there are only 15 minutes. You have to be fast because this is the lecture. You have to use the glue, or we are giving you material, and make the product for him. And then you can submit the. Actually, I wanted you to come here and speak about it, but you can show us after the lecture or it can. So start, now split yourself.